are in the simulation.
That's why something like MATLAB.
What you see in MATLAB?
No, simulation.
They are not real signals. They are simulated signals. Hopefully they are close to real things, and that allows you to try things which you cannot otherwise do. For example, the whole of India had only one multi-channel signal generator. IIT Kharagpur had it for some time. No other IIT had it. Even the Indian Institute of Science did not have it. But today, same capabilities, anybody here with MATLAB, lab, you can do it. Okay? So simulation has allowed a large number of people to do interesting things which was physically not possible earlier due to cost issues. Okay. Next. Coming to the textbook part, representation. How do I mathematically characterize? What do I mean by characterizing the signal? Is it periodic? Is it aperiodic? Is it chaotic? Right? Is it AC, DC? Is it time invariant, shift invariant? What is about the phase? So many characteristics. Just like the characteristics for people. Reliable, hardworking, lazy, so many characteristics. Similar characteristics for signals. Because once you characterize a signal, the way you process will be different. Suppose you say the signal is periodic, you are not worried about processing beyond a period. Enough. Knowledge of one period is enough. Suppose you say it's aperiodic, you already have been troubled, you have to do something else. Suppose it is chaotic, even more difficult. So, characterization is important for you to pick the right approach to analyze data. Okay? The other thing is representation. Okay? How do I represent it? Representation is done for two reasons. One, to understand it ourselves. Second, to convey that information to somebody else. That's why you need representation. Somebody says A cos omega t. Everybody understands it's a sinusoid. I can also take a simple pendulum and do like this. Right? That's also A cos omega t. Right? Somebody will say make it more complicated. Real part of e to the power j omega t. Right? So there are many ways to represent the same information. How do I represent A cos omega t digitally? I will take a cosine wave, sample it, quantize it, convert it into a 8-bit code. That's how your calculator chips work, generating cosine functions and sine functions. I pre-store that data, depending on 8-bit or 16-bit accuracy. So, different way to represent. The reason is, we want to eventually manipulate. That's interesting. When I say signal processing, one aspect of signal processing is signal manipulation. There are two ways to manipulate. One, you have a bad signal. You want to make it good. What do I mean by bad signal? What I see in the room here. So many radio waves. Very weak. I'm unable to hear. I want to hear Lata Mangeshkar sing. I know there is a channel in which her songs are played, but I have to tune it, it will be corrupted by noise, I have to filter it, it is too weak, I have to amplify it. That's the other is extraction. See, many times the information as signal does not come very nice. It is always buried in noise, mostly additive noise. So I want to extract that. I want to extract signal from a combination of signal and noise. That's why the SNR ratio is so important. When I say filter is good, simply says the signal to noise ratio is increased. Why signal to noise ratio has to be increased? Because signal comes with noise. Like all our test papers. All our test paper, our exam papers is okay answers with lot of bad things written. So we have to extract the good answers from that before we give marks. Right? That's why everybody wants objective exam. Objective exam, easy to correct. Right? Easy to score. very difficult to learn. Because you want an easy answer and an easy question, learning becomes difficult through a very objective process all the time. But that season to noise ratio is very high there, very high.
Okay.
Then interaction. Most important thing is not just isolation, interaction. One signal interacting with another. For example, the signal due to muscle movement interacts with the cardiac cycle. So people with weak hearts, hole in the heart or the wall, all these are picked up. Even more interesting, typically very important problem in India, for which I am working with a couple of companies. I want to know for a woman whether the fetus is alive. Because a pregnant lady, if the fetus dies within 24 hours, if the fetus is not removed, the dead fetus will start poisoning the mother. So detecting the aliveness of a baby's fetus, very challenging, because I can only pick up mother's heartbeat. I can put ECG monitors and pick up mother's heartbeat. How do I pick up baby's heartbeat? I cannot insert probes inside. So from the mother's heartbeat, I have to extract, because mother's heartbeat is already interacting with the baby's heartbeat. Beautiful LMS adaptive filter does the job. The instrument is called fetal monitor, and all the small nursing homes also have fetal monitor. Simple adaptive LMS filter is what is implemented. It records mother's heartbeat, dynamically adjusts the delay, takes a mother's heartbeat, a delayed copy of the mother's heartbeat, and subtracts. Suddenly on the screen, baby's heartbeat will come. And if the baby's heartbeat shows continuous this thing, say okay, there is no problem. So such interesting things, because many interesting signals are associated with noise and they are interactive in nature. Very rarely you will get signals like you see in MATLAB plots. So MATLAB plot signals are only for classroom work. Next. Okay. So generation, storing, simulating and synthesizing signals. This mainly the idea of signal processing. Again, I mentioned signal design is a serious activity which we don't do. I think there are only two or three people in India who actually do signal design. Others don't do. In the world, there are about 10-20 people who do signal design. There are thousands of people who do signal processing. Signal design, very few people do, because the type of problems are like that, but it's very challenging. Next. So what are the challenges? X-ray gamma rays. Extremely high frequency. You cannot do DSP of X-ray signals. You cannot do DSP of gamma ray signals or cosmic ray pulsars and cosmic this. It is still analog domain, because I cannot sample. In some other cases, like tsunami and signals from most, the amplitude is so high, the energy is so high, the frequency is so low, I cannot do anything. I can only process after the tsunami has washed the building away. Then I can see how many people died, how many trees fell, how many railway tracks disappeared, all that. I can count later. Postmortem is very easy in most. Okay. Then, like I said, baby's heartbeat from mother's heartbeat. And signals that track God's particle. For example, this. This is the type of tracking that resulted in Nobel Prize for so-called Higgs boson. 2 million, that is 20 lakh signals had to be tracked, from which two correct signals only gave the answer. So it's called needle in a haystack problem. I have to search 20 lakh signals one by one, and my chances of getting two correct out of that is the best I can hope for. And it actually happened. So today they are able to do this extreme type of signal processing. But it's very challenging. Only one place in the world can do that. Not all of us. Even we don't have facility, we don't have resources. we cannot bring the resources. Okay? So these are the kind of problems that are there, and today new problems are coming. For example, most of electronics has become interdisciplinary. That's why electronics jobs are not available, core jobs, because core electronics has shifted to many interesting things. Today, an electronic company in France is building drones, purely electromechanical component, drones. But to fight the drones, there is another veterinary science college which has come forward. They are training eagles to fight the drones. So there is electronic lab, one side electronics, another embedded system, R processor, another side baby eagles. So a good electronics engineer should know eagles and R. If you know ARM, you can't do anything useful. If you know eagles, you can enjoy but cannot do much. So this is the kind of thing that's happening. Okay, next. We are familiar with the idea of voltage, power and frequency, typically ECG, heartbeat, CT scan, MRI, are also signals. So slowly but surely, thanks to cheap image sensors today, 25 years back, the most expensive item in a house was a camera. Most expensive item. Even today, there are analog cameras which cost about 5 to 6 lakh rupees each, typically Hasselblad, which went on to the Apollo moon. The first photographs of the moon when Armstrong landed was a Hasselblad camera. Oh, Hasselblad is like Rolex watch advertisement. They make Roger Federer give advertisement. Similarly, Neil Armstrong gave an advertisement for Hasselblad. One advertisement a year in National Geographic. That's all they would do because they know they are very good. Okay. But today, one of the cheapest items in the world is camera. Everything has a camera because the image sensor has become very cheap. Therefore, the amount of image signals is far more than waveform signals. So the future is dominated by image signals, not by waveform signals. Therefore, to do image processing very well, you must learn signal processing well, which means you need to learn signals and systems very well. Okay? Then MP3, DVD, high definition TV. Today signal processing has changed a lot. Some of the best signal processing, and I say best, people who make a lot of money, are people who are in financial institution. They are doing signal processing of stock market data. Because stock market waveforms goes like this, right? Analyze that, put a Kalman filter, predict what is going to happen, invest that money, make. I know people who make $1 million every day, but they are very good DSP people, not MCOM people, not finance people. So even if you go to MIT, Harvard, Stanford, any of the big places, Georgia Tech, all the undergraduate students do signal systems, DSP, they do statistical signal processing. Fourth course is finance and portfolio management. So they are experts in stock market. They don't look for jobs. They earn their entire lifetime money in 1 year, or they go to jail, whichever is easy. Okay. Then today, infrared and night vision. Thanks to earlier, we would only get images during daytime or under illumination. Today, because of surveillance in the society, more and more poor illumination images, video images are surveillance. All the big cities in Europe today have 24 hours camera recording people, goes to police, everything. So large number of crime is anticipated and prevented. So crime prevention dominates rather than crime detection. So stock market, so many unconventional things are coming for signal processing. Next. So basic signals representation, it can be in time. Tadar avatar of it is frequency. But many interesting things which were not classified before is the idea of a signal which is changing both in time and frequency continuously. And they are interesting signals. They were not processed before because people did not know how to process. Example, Fourier. Fourier did not know time series analysis or time frequency analysis. He knew time analysis. He converted to frequency domain, but he did not handle time frequency even though it was his favorite. because all music is time frequency analysis. I said music is very interesting. Compared to lecture, music is better. Music is better because it is a signal which is continuously changing in time and frequency. If I do time analysis, it is wrong. If I do Fourier techniques, it is wrong. I must do combine time and frequency. And in that, you have two avatars, continuous and discrete, continuous and discrete, continuous. Suppose the signal is another avatar, is it deterministic? What do I mean by deterministic signal? Given the present value, at a later time t, I can predict its value. Good example is a cos omega t. So given the value a, omega and t, I can always find what is the value of a cos omega t plus tau. Then tau is any arbitrary number. E to the power minus at. Given e to the power minus at at time equal to 2 seconds, I know what the value of e to the power minus at at t equal to 5 seconds. Predictable. Okay. So, deterministic. The other is random. What is random? I cannot predict it. So, when I cannot predict, what do? I take probability. I take ideas of probability the moment it is random. I still want to estimate something about that. Therefore, I will estimate ideas of mean and variance and stationarity, non-stationarity, so many issues. Mean, variance, third moment, fourth moment, nth moment, higher order statistics, all that. There's a new category just like time frequency analysis, which is called a chaotic signal. A chaotic signal is not deterministic. It is not random. It appears random, but has hidden determinism. A very good example is Marina Beach. When you stand in front of the Marina Beach and observe, you have to observe. You have to be very patient to learn things well in life. So if you stand and observe slowly, count, start observing. After half an hour, you will be able to get a pattern. Ah, the fourth wave will come and hit my leg. The third wave will make ripples and go back. The seventh wave will overcome me and go far beyond me. You will get a hidden pattern from what appears to be extremely random. Heart attack is that. Heart attack is chaotic. Chennai traffic is chaotic. Given the journey I did for 2.5 hours, by American standard, we should have had at least 150 accidents. We did not have even one. So it appears very disturbing, but our Indian life is also like that. Our university exams are also like that. Yeah. So, chaotic. And if it is deterministic, two things. Is it periodic or aperiodic? If it's periodic, I know within a period I calculate things. If it's aperiodic, I have to find something else. Typically, if it's periodic, I will do Fourier series. If it's aperiodic, I have to do Fourier transform. That's kind of thing that appears to me. Next. You can see here, like all our names in English is made up of basic alphabets A to Z. For today, the names include 0 to 9, alphanumeric. I don't know, many of your children later, right, may have names like ABC 1, 2, 3. So, I don't know. I think there's already some name. Amma is block. I think if you go to website, email account, you'll see Amma 1, Amma 2, Amma 3. Because I think close to 1 million Ammas are there now in Tamil Nadu. So, it will come, alphanumeric will come. So, what are the basic signals? Basic signals in continuous time is impulse, unit step, exponential and sinusoid. Very important to understand that all these things built on calculus and continuity. 250 years we have done calculus, d by dt. Integration and differentiation we have done. All of our signals were continuous because we wanted to differentiate and integrate. 250 years before, there was no calculus. Before Newton and Leibniz, there was no calculus. Now there is less calculus. In another 50 years, there will not be calculus. The things will change. It will all be discrete. discrete impulse, discrete step, exponential sequence, discrete sinusoid, non-calculus power series. So, just like what you did in class 8 and 9, sum to n terms of an algebraic series, sum to n terms of a geometric series, power series, Taylor series, those such things will come. Counting will dominate calculus. So if you see implementation in digital form, there is no calculus. Ideas of calculus will be there, everything will be calculated. So calculation and counting will dominate from now on. Next. So what do I mean by signal systems or a DSP problem? Most universal problem. You have an input, it goes to the system, generates an output. There is a relationship between the input and the system. We call it convolution. Why we call it convolution is because we don't understand what is happening. Mental convolution and stuff. Okay. Leave that aside. For a moment, leave that aside. And see what we mean by this input and output. I have an input, goes to a system, produces an output. It's called an input-output model. Input-output model is universal. For example, all of you here, you are the inputs to this university. You will come out after 4 years or 8 semesters. Give or take 1 or 2 semesters, that's it. So, your y of t is x of t minus 8, delayed by 8 semesters, multiplied by alpha. Alpha is less than 1. So, you were better before joining this college, you got worse after that. Attendance. Suppose you join Stanford or MIT, y of t is alpha times x of t minus 8. But alpha is guaranteed to be at least 10. That's the reason why we want to join there. Why we want to join a system like Stanford or MIT or IIT is, we are hoping that even with bad inputs, we pick up better outputs. True. That's why everybody says, I want to put him to a good school, I want to put him to a good college, I want to send him to a good teacher, so that a bad input becomes better output. True. See, input-output property. The same applies to your eating. So, input-output system is a universal model. We cannot handle everything. Can I do differential equation of Veltech University? I can't do that. But it's an input-output problem, no doubt about that. I can make my life easier by saying it's an input-output model. Treating linearity property. Linearity simply means output is in some way related to the input proportionally. With some delay, some attenuation. So, this is something that we treat as system. So, what does system do? System has the property that given the present input and the conditions, and the characteristics of the system, future outputs can be determined. Why did George Bush send his twin daughters, to Stanford University? Because he knew his house is very bad house, very bad system. Better to send them to a better system so that they become better than the father. Hopefully we'll have to wait for some time to see. They will definitely be better than the father. The father was very bad, so obvious. That's why you see all the politicians' children are sent to America and Europe in schools to study. Because they create very bad schools here. They know very well. Whenever they go to a college or university, first thing I ask is, are your children studying here? If this university and college is not good for your children, why should it be good for other children? First test to see whether your system is good or bad, your own commitment. First test is litmus test. So we want a good system. More important, we characterize the system. Suppose somebody says low pass, high pass. What do I mean by low pass? Let's be very clear. Every system is good. Are high pass filters bad? Why should low pass filters only be good? High pass filters are also good. If your signal is one of having very high frequency and you want something done there, you better have a high pass filter. So there is really no system which is bad. You need a very compatible input with the system, or you must know what system to use given an input so that output is good. This is system design. Given the system and an input, what is the output? Is signal analysis. Signal analysis is easy. System analysis is easy. System design is difficult. What we do, we will come back to convolution later, but we generally avoid convolution. One interesting thing is, if something is difficult in one domain, it will be easy in another domain. Therefore, if your test is very difficult, assignment will be very easy. That's why all of you want assignment. Why you want assignment? Because test means you have to write in the class. Assignment means you can write in the hostel. One of them can write, all others know what to do about it. And you will see why all this is successful. The person who copies the assignment in the hostel will submit it first to the teacher. Teachers are generally very stupid. Invariably, teacher always gives maximum marks to the one who has copied very correctly and submitted on time. The fellow who has worked correctly, today thanks to internet, it is even worse. Last year, I got some student from US to say they have an assignment in linear algebra to be submitted by midnight. So please work one or two problems for me in India here and send it back. I will put it and submit it, because at 12 o'clock midnight, automatically the inbox closes for that assignment. So this is what is happening. People are designing very nice systems today. Students are very good at designing good systems. So don't worry about the teachers. Yeah. So typically, one associates an idea of convolution. Convolution is filtering. Filtering is to the idea of filter design. For 50 years, signal system meant filter design. Meaning, I want to design a system because input is not under my control. Input is there. I must design a system so that output is very good. I study the characteristics of the input, design appropriately filter, which is really filter design problem. Initially, the filter design was analog. You must realize all the books that you read now as signal system was done by very hard work. People did not have calculator. They were using logarithmic table and designing. Your famous Rabiner and Gold, Oppenheim and Schaffer, first books on DSP. Rabiner and Gold were laboratory assistants for original DSP people who were doing log table calculations whenever they asked. They said, okay, give me the fourth root of the Butterworth polynomial, calculate quickly and give use tables and give it. That's what Rabiner and Gold were doing. People were designing the first filters. And after that, they were carrying very carefully 4-bit registers. Because 4-bit registers were $100 those days. And they wanted 8-bit register to make the first digital telephone. 8-bit registers. Today, 512 registers are thrown on the lab, but we don't know how to use. Okay. So next, this is really what it is. What we mean by convolution, we put an input, get an output based on the system. System has many interesting properties. The system is characterized by properties. What are the properties? Time and shift invariant. What do I mean by time and shift invariant? Why do I need the property of time and shift invariant? So, what do I mean by time or shift invariant? Present input, system, present output. Suppose I delay this input by 24 hours, same system, I get an output, which is this output delayed by 24 hours. So, if I delay the input, I get a response which is as good as delaying the response. So, what I do today, if I do the same thing tomorrow, answer will be the same. Why I need this is for all our products. We bought a mobile phone 3 months back. It was made in Finland. Nokia made it. They tested it. It worked. You brought it here and sold it. Somebody sold it to you. You bought it here. It is 3 months since it was manufactured. You also try. It doesn't work. Or you say hello, I will give you a picture out. Some other output. No product will work if the property of time invariance and shift invariance is not there. What works in America should work here if I give the same type of voice input. Okay. Second property of stable. The first property is time and shift, another property is linearity. Why do I want system to be linear? First reason why I want it to be linear is because that's the only thing I know how to solve. Non-linear I cannot solve. Linear, I solve, you solve, we both get the same answer. I solve a small problem, I get confidence to solve a large problem if it is linear. If it is non-linear, if I solve y equal to x squared, there is no guarantee I can solve y equal to x cubed. But if it's linear, if I can solve d squared theta by dt squared, I can solve d cubed theta by dt cubed also. So, second order differential equation, if I know how to solve, I also know how to solve third order differential equation. But if it is non-linear, second order non-linearity, if I know how to solve, absolutely no guarantee that I know how to solve third order. So, non-linearity, each is different. Each order is different, each type of nonlinearity is different. So what to do? Don't touch it. Why make life difficult for everybody? Hey, let's make life easy for all. Make it linear, nth order, linear differential equation with constant coefficient. N can be 100, N can be 200. All I need to know is N is equal to 1, N is equal to 2. That is all the working need. So linearity and shift at time invariant is equivalent of linear convolution. The other consequence of linearity is big is equal to sum of small. Therefore, when I have a bad complicated system, I can break it into very small, nice system, solve. Why do you have so many sections? Why do you have so many sections in your college or your university? Why not put everybody into one room? Put a big screen, big microphone. Every day will be political speech. So even in Singapore, classes are, one class is 650 students. Teacher will teach only once. Very good teacher, 650 students. But after that, all the classes are broken to size of 20. Research scholars and senior research associates will handle classes of 20 for tutorials to solve problems. Even in MIT, IIT also now, most of the theory classes are one big class, 500, 600 class of size. Once you teach properly, actual learning, tutorials and tests conducted by small groups. Okay. So, that's the idea of linearity. Fourier series, right? It's a consequence of linearity. Bad signal, make it into linear combination of nice signals. Solve each nice signal because you know how to solve nice things. What you don't know is how to solve difficult things. hopefully, if the difficulty is a sum of small nice things, you win. When it's not, you lose even badly. Don't worry about that. Okay? Then the idea of causality. What do I mean by causality? There are two things about causality. One, whenever you have physical components, they are causal. Causality means output cannot be before input. Like what you did today afternoon. Before I arrived into this hall, you were all seated. You anticipated my arrival here. Such behavior is non-causal. Such behavior is non-causal. Humans are interesting. We have memory. Therefore, we are both causal and non-causal. Causal, then it is. Do you start answering the exam before the question paper is given? Many of you do that because you have already prepared the question paper mentally. Anticipated question paper. So, humans are interesting because of memory, they have both causal and non-causal behavior. Physical systems, no. Inductor, capacitor, resistor, all these are passive elements who are causal in nature. They will give you a current only after the charge is put into the capacitor, not before that. Okay? So, whenever you have causal systems, physical systems are causal generally, but today, because of programming environment, non-causal behavior is possible because in a programming environment induces memory into a dynamic system like us. Therefore, prediction, anticipated results are very common today, which was not the case earlier. And the last one is, of course, one is stable. What do I mean by stable? Input is good, output is also good. The system will not make a good input into bad output. Bad input can be improved, but very rarely a good input will be converted to bad output. That happens in Indian education system. Good students are converted to bad political leaders. We have in our college two of the alumnus are Mysore Karnataka chief ministers. Our present chief minister is also from our college only. So we are able to produce only such people. We are not able to produce good scientists. So good scientists are converted to bad political leaders. But that doesn't happen. Stable system will make sure that even if you put something bad, nothing worse than that will happen. Okay? So the truth is that we build stable systems. We want systems to be stable. But the instability is prevented. But instability is also used as an advantage. For example, the fighter aircrafts in Israel, particularly the American aircraft which they took, they modified, they shift, it's called pole shifting controller. Whenever an enemy missile comes, the aircraft will shift its poles to the right half of its plane, making the plane unstable. So for 20 to 30 seconds, pilot has no control over the plane. Plane misbehaves. Therefore, the enemy aircraft which is behaving well cannot detect it or. So that's how they avoid the missiles and this thing. After 2 or 3 minutes, again the poles are shifted back to left half of his plane and the pilot takes control over it. We do that. Many of you students may not do that, but many of teachers I know. Teachers sometimes behave unstable and they want to avoid work. So you behave unstable so that your head of the department is afraid to give you any work. You can go to the mall very early every day. So unstable behavior is also there. But instability is used sometimes as an advantage. One good thing about instability is instability ensures oscillation. So many times when we want oscillation, we want unstable performance, marginally unstable performance. Then last thing is invertible. Invertible means the following. I have an input, went to the system, gave me an output. Can I find another system here? If I give the input, output comes back. Can I recover the input from its output? It's called deconvolution. Most difficult, most practical problem. All interesting problems are deconvolution. That is why it is not in your syllabus. Only convolution is there, deconvolution is not there. CT scanner, ECG, petroleum exploration, tsunami detection, all interesting practical problems are deconvolution. You will study later that deconvolution is always imperfect. Approximate deconvolution is a good answer. Your CT scanner, your fetal monitors, all these are deconvolution problems. 99% of practical problems are deconvolution because the principle of practical problems is convolution. Therefore, the answer is deconvolution. Very difficult, let me tell you, because it's an endless topic. You deconvolve in one way, there are another 100 ways to deconvolve. The deconvolution you do in one way cannot be applied to other problems. So all these are issues. Okay? Next. This is really one. So convolution is generally defined in time domain because all of us have one common thing. All of us have one common thing. Some are faculty, men, boy students, lady faculty, girl students, outsiders, insiders, in between, all kinds of people, but all of us have one common thing. All of us have x-axis as time. All of us have x-axis as time. That's why when you meet your friend, you say hello to your friend, you say, okay, I'll see you tomorrow. You will not say, I'll see you yesterday. So your faculty said, oh, so and so is coming. They said, they didn't say, he has already come. He is coming. So x-axis is common for all of us in terms of time, which is called existence. It's also causality. So whenever we talk to each other, whenever we describe system behavior, we are assuming the x-axis is time. The reason is very clear. Time and space started together at Big Bang. When the Big Bang occurred, time was created. Space was created simultaneously. That's the idea of space-time. And because heat flows from hotter location to colder location, the time is always forward. Time is never negative. Time never goes backward. Time always goes forward because natural heat always goes from hot to cold. So that's when will it end? It will end when all of us are not there. Don't worry. So physical existence, causal fact is time domain. Whereas we don't like that. Humans are very clever. Humans are very clever to change the domain. Many of you, particularly ladies, all of you are wearing very colorful clothes. Different colors. It's a very monotonous color. Black, blue, red, dark. You are like rainbow colors. Tell me honestly, how many of you bought your clothes at 1 p.m. in the afternoon? How many of you went in the afternoon at 1 o'clock and bought the clothes? Or 1 o'clock? You always buy at 1 o'clock? Why? Convenient time. No rush in the shop. Okay. You are having a yellowish top. Black, yellow, whatever. Is it yellow because you bought it at 12 o'clock? Suppose you had bought it at 9, 10 o'clock. What color it would have been? All of you bought many colors. Did you select the color or you selected the time at which you bought? So any time you would have bought that color only. So color is independent of time, right? Color is a new domain, frequency domain. So all colorful things are in frequency domain. All quality things are in frequency domain. All existent things are in time domain. Therefore, whenever you want something nice to be done, you cannot stay in time domain. You have to shift to frequency domain, then do your job. That is why all your filters are designed in frequency domain. How many design filters in time domain? How many design filters in time domain? My PhD was that I tried designing filters in time. It took 5 years. Nothing happened. I got my PhD. So I finally proved that kind of printers are not very helpful. There are hundreds of techniques in frequency domain. There are only two techniques in time domain. So somebody had done it, I discovered it independently. It works, but there is no guarantee it will work well. If it works well, enjoy. If it doesn't work well, don't complain. In frequency domain, no such problems. If it doesn't work well, you can improve on that. You can increase the order, you can increase the decrease aggregation, all that you can do. Time domain, no. That's why PhD is called time pass filters. 5 and a half years. Interesting. But I got a very good compliment because one of the leading DSP man in the world is Sidney Peres, Texas. He had come, he saw my thesis. He said, "You are a wonderful guy. You are the only person who has wasted as much time as I have done in my life trying to go." We are very good friends in Quantum. So he said, "I'm glad you tried because nobody tries it. You showed that, you know, it's worth doing a PhD by not getting results." But it's an excellent teacher, not all about one of the best teachers of the process. So, quality of signal. Therefore, whenever you want to process information, you must process for quality. Quality of information is available to in transform domain. Fourier is one, Laplace is another, if it is continuous. If it is discrete, you have set transform, it does both. But be very careful. Even as we laugh, the subtle things are missing from you. Why we do time domain filters is, if you are doing tsunami signal processing, earthquake signal processing, you cannot design in frequency domain. You have to design in time. That's why if attempting difficult problems may not give you good results, but it gives you excellent understanding of the subject. Even now, if somebody can attempt tsunami signal processing, it is me, I know. Because I know what is a bad thing to be done there. Whether it works well, I don't know. But so as we joke around, we also have fun. We always have fun. Oh, you never got any results. You got a PhD. Okay, go. Have fun, but difficult. It's not that we do for kicks. There are difficult problems left unsolved even now by many people. Nobody attempts that. So somebody must try something funny. You may get reward, you may not get reward. I got very good reward. I never got a job after that. So it's okay, it's a good reward. I got 300 days leave a year. Okay, next step. Okay, so this is really what is filtering. I have a signal, I have a system. What is the difference between signal and system? No difference. I could have put this as X of N, this as X of N. So signal and system are two sides of the same coin. You should never tell a signal without telling a system, or never tell a system without telling the signal is what it is. So, what really happened, put the previous slide. Previous. So when you say signal is interacting with the system, no such thing is happening. Signal is interacting with the signal equivalent of the system. These are two signals interacting, convolution. A signal will not convolve with a resistor or an inductor. Signal will convolve with another signal. So, when you say signal equivalent of system, two things happen. Impulse response. DSP and communication people insist on impulse response. Control system people say step response is good enough. The reason is very clear. Control system problems are mostly low frequency problems, where the impulse response for low frequency is very close to the step response for low frequency. So I don't have problem. In communication, large number of problems are worked at high frequency also. Therefore, impulse response is very important for communication. That's all the difference. Otherwise, there is no conceptual difference. Next. Yeah, so whenever I convert, which is interaction, becomes long, equivalently you see what happens. This was the frequency domain representation, TTFT basically of this. This is the frequency domain representation of that. Multiplication, this part was all zero here, this part will go away. This is what I mean by filtering. Okay? So whenever I expand the signal in one domain, it will shrink in another, like according to harmony. Reverse is also true. If I shrink in time domain, it will expand in frequency domain. Well, this is interesting property of Fourier and his cousins. It has also has other implications in communication, circuit design, like time bandwidth product, etc. Next. So what we mean by filter design is basically get me a profile with x-axis as frequency, x-axis as time. Get me a profile, and that profile in frequency domain, where the y-axis is frequency profile squared. Why I take squared is basically I want energy of the signal, not amplitude of the signal, because energy is information and energy is proportional to square of the signal. For example, in your circuit theory, you have a voltage and a resistance R, current passes through that, the energy is proportional to I squared R or V squared by R. Therefore, energy of a passive circuit is proportional to V squared or proportional to I squared.